communicates with branches of subclavian artery. In your questions can be the following structure of the question. What are cerebral branches of the carotid internal artery? Cerebral anterior with communication anterior, cerebral medial, choroid, and cerebral posterior. And communication posterior. And communication posterior. Cerebral posterior, this is from subclavian system, do you see? But another branch, it is called arterial cerebral circle, about which I explained you. If the blood will not come to the brain by subdivision of the carotid internal artery, it will come, do you see, from subclavian. You can see, do you see, by green vectors, do you see, I draw the arterial cerebral circle. What arteries complete into the arterial cerebral circle? By name of the scientist, it is called Willisi circle, Willisi circle. You can see cerebral anterior communication anterior, cerebral posterior communication posterior. Do you see? I draw you circulation of the blood. It is very easy. Cerebral anterior communication anterior, cerebral posterior communication posterior. Did you understand? Cerebral anterior communication anterior, cerebral posterior communication posterior. If you want cerebral anterior, cerebral posterior communication posterior. Do you see the arteries which do the circle? Do you see? Mm-hmm. You can see this. Do you see vertebral artery? It came from subclavian arteries. Subclavian artery we will study by next time. At first you will read at home, because if I explain you without your primary knowledges, you don't have any memory. Listen to me. You can see external carotid artery. External carotid artery, it, do you see, gives, look at me, three branches in front. They are called anterior group. Three branches behind. They are called posterior group. And three branches between them is called the medial group. Here, students cut one artery. This, do you see, from beginning of the carotid external artery, in front of, do you see, and below, directs branch to the anterior side of the thyroid gland, from right side and from left side. It is called thyroid superior artery. It comes and subdivides right and left anastomosis and do net plexus on the anterior side of the thyroid gland. Before, do you see, division into the distal branches, thyroid superior artery gives branch, before production of the plexus net, it gives branch to the larynx, which is called laryngeal superior. Why thyroid superior? Why laryngeal superior? These branches came to the larynx and to the thyroid gland from upper. Do you see? You can see thyroid superior before its subdivision and production of the thyroid arterial plexus, it gave to the larynx, laryngeal superior artery. Laryngeal superior artery by its subdivisions supplies the all elements of the larynx, cartilages, ligaments, muscles, which are placed above in the vocal fold. Do you understand? Okay. Next artery, look please here. This artery enters into the oral cavity behind of the free margin of the myofascial muscle. On the neck, if you remember, we have a lingual or pirogov by name of the scientist, lingual because it is for the list of the lingual artery. This you can see is, do you see,
posterior margin of the myelohyoid muscle. This is posterior belly of the digastric muscle. And here do you see, like my stick must enter inside, my must exit from outside, hypoglossal nerve. Here is smaller triangle, lingual triangle, myelohyoid muscle, posterior belly of the digastric and hypoglossal nerve. Between these objects, by this triangle in the oral cavity enters the, do you see, lingual artery. Do you see? Lingual artery enters into the oral cavity and goes inside into the tongue on its side. When it comes into the tongue, it is called arteria profunda lingua, deep lingual artery. When do you see it passes like deep lingual artery through the body of the tongue, it gives three or four dorsal lingual arteries, arteria dorsalis lingua, to the back of the tongue. Why? Because many arteries advise they go to the back. Because here we have many nerve receptors, taste receptors and receptors for the genial sensory. You can see lingual artery comes into the oral cavity through the lingual triangle and enters into the tongue where it travels by another name, arteria profunda lingua. And when it goes through the body of the tongue, it gives arteria dorsalis lingua to the back of the tongue. Before its visit into the tongue, it gives in the oral cavity sublingual artery for the blood supply of the sublingual gland and floor of the mouth. This is lingual artery. Do you understand? Another artery from lower to upper crosses mandible, passes obliquely through the face and comes to the angle of the eye. This artery is called arteria facialis, facial artery. Facial artery, it goes near the submandible gland, gives submandible branch to this gland. It does it by muscular branches, supplies the all mimic or emotion muscles of the face. Very biggest branches it gives into the lower lip, into the upper lip. They are called labial superior, labial inferior. Labial superior from right, anastomosis with labial superior from left. Labial inferior from right, anastomosis with labial inferior from left. You can see here, do you see facial artery changes its name and is called angular artery. If you remember, it anastomosis with arteria dorsalis nasi, dorsal nasal artery from carotid internal system. Do you remember? You can see arteria facialis. The anterior group includes arteria tyroidea superior, arteria lingualis, and arteria facialis. But listen to me, sometimes we, by boys, for example, by special apparatus for the cleaning of the hairs, women do you see by some plastic manipulations, do you see, can destroy the subdivisions of the facial artery. And for us, it's important to decrease or to stop the bleeding. What we can do? We can press facial artery to the mandible and the bleeding will stop. Where we press, do you see, put your palmar sides on the lateral sides of the head and do the lifting of the mandible, lifting and do you see, open and close the mouth. By palpation, you will find masseter muscle, do you see? And you can differentiate by palpation its anterior margin. In front of then the anterior margin of the masseter muscle, for example, this is masseter muscle, and by anterior margin in front of you will press it. Do you see? You can see this is this information about anterior group of the carotid external artery. It includes thyroid, superior, lingual, and facial. Posterior group, do you see, this is external acoustic meatus. Do you see? Here must be what? Ear. That? Yeah. You can see The following branches, one branch goes behind of the ear, supplies this region and back of the ear. It's called auricularis posterior, auricle posterior. Another branch. Another artery, it, do you see, goes by arterial occipital groove. Do you see, this is mastoid process, process mastoidosis, this is incisor mastoidal notch, and this is groove for the occipital artery, sulcus arteria occipitalis, artery occipital groove. It goes through the occipital region to the parietal region. Do you understand? It's called artery occipitalis. But do you see mastoid opening? Do you remember I said you, when we started the skull, here exits vein. Do you remember? And we can decrease the vein pressure if we will locate here the leech. Do you remember I explained you? My dear, your young memory is very bad. I explained you about leech when we started the temporal bone. Explained. Here we can locate the leech. Leech will find this open by which vein from sigmoid sinus, do you see, exits and will suck the blood and we will decrease the vein pressure in the skull. But opposite then the exit of the vein from occipital artery by mastoid open into the posterior cranial fossa will come meningeal posterior artery. Do you remember from ophthalmic? Meningeal anterior. From occipital, meningeal posterior. Did you understand? Occipital artery passes through the occipital region to the parietal, supplies all things on its way, periosteum, occipital muscle, skin, comes to the parietal region and gives you the meningeal posterior branch into the posterior cranial fossa. But look this here. This is carotid external artery, do you see? And here from mastoid process to the sternum and clavicle directs what? Sternocleidomastoid muscle. From carotid external artery to the sternocleidomastoid muscle will go the same artery, sternocleidomastoid artery. You can see this is the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Here will be sternocleidomastoid artery. Here will be auricle posterior, and here will be occipital. Mm. These are posterior posterior branches. Sternocleidomastoid, auricle posterior, auricularis posterior, and arteria occipitalis. Did you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Next time I will ask you all things. And medial group. Listen to me. Medial group. It divides into three. Look this here. One lies very externally, behind of the skin. Another goes very deeply, joins to the lateral wall of the pharynx, and goes vertically above. It's called pharyngeal ascending. Another which lies very externally is called temporal superficial. And another, look here, like concrete, continuation of the carotid external artery, do you see? This will be temporal superficial, this will be pharyngeal ascending, and here, do you see, will get horizontal position. Here, do you see, it is not very correctly because it must locate behind of the mandible. Do you see? You can see this artery is called temporal superficial. It is placed in front of the ear, here. It passes through the parotid gland, gives glandular branches to the gland. It, do you see, divides above into the frontal branch, you can see, which anastomosis with supraorbital branch of the ophthalmic artery from carotid internal system. Distant. You can see, here do you see, it gives parietal branch, which anastomosis
with continuation of the occipital artery. Occipital, do you see? From carotid external. Anastomosis with parietal branch from temporal superficial from carotid external. Carotid external, this is one system. It anastomosis, do you see, by its distal branches. This will be anastomosis of the one system. Do you see? Carotid external, temporal superficial, frontal, anastomosis with supraorbital from ophthalmic, ophthalmic from carotid internal. This will be anastomosis between two systems. Anastomosis between two systems, no, they are very important because if the one system will be closed, another system will bring blood. Anastomosis in one system, no, so comfort. Because if the genial system will be closed, the object will not be supplied. Do you see? Listen to me. For next time, you will find in the book anastomosis and you will complete them into your book. I will check. Because for me, it's not important to listen. Carotid internal artery gives this, this, and this branches. This is like poem. For me, it's important to know about your knowledges which you by which you will do treatment. You can press oligate by threads the artery or not. If this object gets blood by two or three different arteries, you can, do you see, by threads press or ligate the some arteries and the organ will be supplied. If, do you see, we don't have anastomosis, you will ligate the arteries after your operation, the organ will necrosis. Do you understand? How to draw, how to complete, how to write or how to complete into your book correctly the anastomosis. Here I gave example. Do you see? Common carotid artery. Arteria carotis communis. No, a common carotid artery cannot draw because for us it is interesting the following. Look here. Carotid internal, do you see, vector, do you see, gives ophthalmic artery. Ophthalmic artery, do you see, vector, gives dorsal nasal artery. Do you see? Dorsal nasal artery, do you see, anastomosis with, do you see, facial by its angular part from what? From carotid external. You can see this artery, do you see, gives this artery. This artery gives this artery. This artery anastomosis with this artery. We get this, we got this artery, do you see, from this. This is it. Mm-hmm. This is scheme how to correct, how correctly to draw the anastomosis. Did you understand?
Yes.
You can see. This is temporal superficial artery. Temporal superficial artery. Again, you can see. Carotid external gives the temporal superficial. Temporal superficial gives parietal. Parietal anastomosis with occipital from carotid external. Anastomosis in one system. Did you understand?
Mm-hmm.
This is temporal superficial artery. Another artery, it joins to the lateral wall of the pharynx and goes above. Goes above and it supplies the pharynx. It supplies the soft palate. Why it supplies the soft palate? Into the pharynx, into the wall of the pharynx, we have continuation of the palatopharyngeal muscle. At first, it does the soft palate and arc. Do you remember palatopharyngeal arc? And after that, it completes into the longitudinal layer of the pharynx. Do you see? It supplies the, do you see, pharynx, soft palate, palatine tonsil, because it is placed between arches, root of the tongue. It supplies tube tonsil, because on the lateral wall of the nasal part of pharynx is placed tube tonsil. And on the lateral wall of the nasal part of the pharynx opens auditive tube by which from lower into the tympanic cavity will come tympanic inferior artery. Listen to me. Tympanic inferior artery is branch of the pharyngeal ascending. Pharyngeal ascending from carotid externa. If you remember, we began today's lesson by carotico-tympanic artery, which is from carotid internal. Do you remember? Because you can see carotid external, it gives pharyngeal ascending. Pharyngeal ascending gives tympanic inferior. Tympanic inferior anastomosis with carotico-tympanic, which came from carotid internal. Listen to me. In your book, you will see this artery, anastomosis with this artery. Now, by this example, you will see carotico-tympanic artery from carotid internal supplies tympanic cavity. By another information, you will see the pharyngeal ascending artery gives tympanic inferior. If he will not be got anastomosis, but if they come to the same object, they cannot come here one, here another, this concrete border, they anastomosis. Do you understand? Because you must train your logic and you must find this anastomosis. Who will find more of anastomosis by next time? I will, do you see, complete into the register the better mark. Do you see? You can see. Pharyngeal ascending is very deep vertical direction. The temporal superficial is externally. Another artery, like concrete, continuation of the carotid external. Do you see this is carotid external? Do you see by its continuation it rotates and gets, do you see, horizontal position? Like here. Do you see? Like here. Maxillary artery, arteria maxillaris. It joins from inside to the neck of the mandible. This will be mandible part of the maxillary artery. It passes through the infratemporal fossa, it is called infratemporal region, and in some books you can find another name, pterygoid region. Why? Because here will be pterygoid lateral, here will be pterygoid medial muscle. It is placed between them, because this region through which it passes, it can have two names. Infratemporal, because this is infratemporal fossa, or pterygoid, because it is placed between pterygoid muscles. And do you see the last? Do you see a part which comes into the pterygopalatine fossa? Do you remember pterygopalatine fossa, which communicates with all topography region of the skull? Do you see this last part which enters into the pterygopalatine fossa is called pterygopalatine region. First region, look please here, mandible region. How it works? Through the short distance, yes? Here do you see into the styloid opening, it gives, do you see, into the medial cranial fossa, meningeal medial artery. Meningeal anterior from ophthalmic, meningeal medial from maxillary, meningeal posterior from occipital. They will anastomosis in the meninges. Do you understand? Look with here. Here, do you see, is placed first region. Look with here. It will give for the blood supply of the mandible and all elements which are placed towards the lower jaw. It gives alveolary inferior artery. Arteria alveolaris inferior. Here will exit to the chin its mental branch. Do you see? You can see arteria alveolaris inferior. Arteria alveolaris. Arteria alveolaris inferior, do you see here? Arteria meningea media, these are so, so big branches of this region. Another, here will be mandible fossa, here petrotympanic fissure. from mandible region of the maxillary artery through the pietrotympanic fissure into the tympanic cavity will come tympanic anterior artery, which will anastomosis with tympanic inferior from pharyngeal ascending and with carotica tympanic. Do you understand? The all arteries which include in their name tympanic, they came for the blood supply with tympanic cavity. Because inside, in the mucous membrane, they will anastomosis. And another branch will enter into the external acoustic meatus and is called arteria profunda auricularis, deep aurical artery. Deep aurical and tympanic anterior, these are smaller branches of the mandibular region or the maxillary artery. Alveolaris inferior and arteria meningea media, they are big branches. Another region of the maxillary artery, this is infratemporal pterygoid. Listen to me. Here will be pterygoid lateral, here will be pterygoid medial muscle, here will be temporal muscle, here will be masseter muscle. What is the name of these all muscles, general name? Masticatory or mastication muscles. And do you see the maxillary artery is placed between them because it will give arteria musculus temporalis, arteria musculus masseter, arteria musculus pterygoidus lateralis, arteria musculus pterygoidus medialis. Понятно? Muscular branches. To the what? Mastication muscles. Do you see dorsal side of the maxilla? Here will be three smaller openings by which from infratemporal region of the maxillary artery to the posterior teeth will direct branches. Arteria alveolaris superior posterior. Three branches from infratemporal region of the maxillary artery. Arteria alveolaris superior posterior. Till what? Till, to the posterior teeth of the upper jaw. Superior upper jaw, posterior. Posterior teeth, they are called molars. Do you see? This is infratemporal region of the maxillary artery, which gave the branches to the muscles and to the posterior teeth. Do you understand? And the last, pterygopalatine region of the maxillary artery. It gives arteria infraorbitalis, which by inferior orbital fissure comes into the orbit, lies into the infraorbital groove, goes deeply into the canal, and here exits. And here it anastomosis with what? Facial artery. Arteria infraorbitalis. Arteria infraorbitalis supplies the lower part of the eye, do you see? It supplies the lower eye anastomosis with palpebral branches, and here it exits. But do you see, here is open and deeply canal, and here is groove. This is canal. From, do you see, deep place of the canal, deep region of the canal, begin arteries, and they direct to the premolars. From anterior region, before infraorbital open, will go arteries, which will go to the anterior teeth. Anterior teeth, incisors and canine, the arteries are called alveolary anterior, superior anterior, to the upper jaw, to the anterior teeth. To the premolars, arteria alveolaris superior medial. This is it. To the incisors and canine, we have arteria alveolaris superior anterior from infraorbital, from maxillary artery, from carotid external system, yes? And to the premolars, we have the same. To the molars, we have the branches from infratemporal region of the same artery. Do you understand? Listen to me. If I will go, do you see, from side, directly I will enter into the nasal cavity. Do you remember pterygopalatine fossa? In front of maxilla, behind pterygoid process inside perpendicular lamin of the palatine bone. This is the horizontal lamin, this is pterygopalatine lamin, this perpendicular lamin of the palatine bone. You can see here is notch, which is closed by body of the sphenoid bone. Here will be sphenopalatine opening. From pterygopalatine fossa into the nasal cavity by sphenopalatine opening comes for the blood of the mucous membrane, well, the blood supply of the mucous membrane, sphenopalatine artery. Sphenopalatine opening, sphenopalatine artery. And below will hang palatine descending artery. Well, sometimes it can be present, sometimes not, because sometimes if it is present, it divides into the greater palatine for the hard palate and lesser palatine for the soft palate. Sometimes these arteries, they go individually. Sometimes they can be a result of the division of the palatine descending. Pterygopalatine region of the maxillary artery gives palatine greater, palatine lesser, gives sphenopalatine, and gives infraorbital with alveolar branches to the teeth. Do you understand? Mandibular region of the maxillary artery gave alveolar inferior, meningeal medial, anterior tympanic, deep auricle. Infratemporal pterygoid region gives muscular branches to the all mastication muscles, gives to the posterior teeth of the upper jaw, arteria alveolaris superior posterior. The pterygopalatine region, it gave infratemporal with, do you see, alveolar superior anterior, alveolar anterior medial. Do you see, it gives sphenopalatine into the nasal cavity and greater palatine, lesser palatine, which can be individual, which can be results of the division of the descending palatine. Did you understand about what I want to inform you? Do you see sphenopalatine? I said you, it comes into the nasal cavity. Yes?
Yes.
Today, if you remember, we gave from ophthalmic artery, ethmoid anterior and posterior. You must understand, they will do anastomosis. If you remember, lesser palatine supplies the soft palate. If you remember, today we gave for the soft palate the branches from pharyngeal ascending. Do you remember? Try to read with attention and try to collect the all anastomosis. Who will complete more of anastomosis? Next time you will collect with another artist communications, and it will be very better for you when you will come on the operative surgery. Mm-hmm. Try to do. And this will be very important for your clinic life. Mm-hmm. Also, my dear, I ask you, work please individually. If any person will collect information from your book of your colleague, I will understand. Because if the colleague, do you see, included this anastomosis, he can describe them. If any person did copy of this anastomosis from his friend, he cannot describe and he cannot understand. For you is important understanding. Do you see? Так, today, my whole lesson, I explained you material. Next time, I will ask this material, and you will prepare individually by yourself subclavian artery. And again, when you will complete subclavian artery has the system, has anastomosis in one system between its branches, and subclavian artery, you can see, anastomosis with carotid internal system, and subclavian artery will anastomosis with carotid external, because it will give from lower thyroid inferior artery with laryngeal inferior. Try to find it with attention. That's all.